Okay, stop me if you've heard this one before, but I have some Silver Age Batman and some Bronze Age Batman that I want to show you. Yes, and these were both shipped media mail. I don't know, I'm so scared now. Like, should I message sellers when I buy comics, don't ship me to media mail? I don't know. Anywho, if you are tuning in for more three pack openings, we will be doing those. But the thing is, I'm out of bags and boards right now, and I have more coming in, hopefully today, but they were already delayed. They were supposed to be coming in tomorrow. And then I went on Amazon and said, oh, I should buy some more just so I have another shipment incoming after that. And they are currently unavailable. So I'm going to have 100 bags and boards, hopefully today. But for now, I don't have any, so I don't feel like unboxing or unwrapping the more of those three packs and finding 10 more copies of XO Manowar number 19 or whatever the hell it was. It was fun doing that, but it was somewhat disappointing. I'm hoping the next two batches will be a little bit better. But as for today's mail, again, Detective Comics all day, baby. So this is Detective Comics number 318. This one again is from 63, I believe, 1963, August. Great Scott, Batwoman has joined forces with the Catman and become the Catwoman. So it's so weird, like these older books feel like they come from an alternate universe with Batwoman, the old style Batwoman becoming Catwoman, but there was a Catwoman, so it's wild and bizarre. This one I think I got in an auction, and I think I paid less than $20 for it. And this is not the oldest detective I have. The one with the whale, I think, was a few months before this one. So that is cool. But that's where we're at. Just Detective Comics all the time. The collections that I got over the weekend, my collection and my friend Frank's collection, didn't have a lot of Bronze Age detective. There's plenty of Batman. At least in mine. I haven't even started to go through Frank's stuff because there's just so damn much of it. And I'm working through my stuff first to kind of get a grip on what's there and what isn't. But we'll get into that more in a future video. But for now, I did another order. This is my third order with eBay seller Talented Online. I cannot recommend this seller enough. If you are looking for Bronze Age Batman and Bronze Age Detective Comics for about $3 a book, you got to buy enough so that you get buy two, get one, or buy three, get one, and then you got to buy enough that you get free shipping on top of that. And then it becomes, in my opinion, worthwhile. And these are just in fantastic condition every time. Most of them are in. Man, this one, I'll show it to you eventually. I'm just feasting my eyes on this gorgeous cover. Okay, this is Detective 517. As I've stated in previous videos, I'm like shying away from the whole CGC thing. I don't know if I would ever submit a book. But I do know from watching other people's YouTube videos that black covers are really hard to get good grades on. But if you look closely, I mean, there's some minor spine ticks here. But man, this cover just pops. And that's the first book on the pile. Gorgeous. All right, next one. Detective Comics 514. On the other end of the color spectrum, this white, the snow. I love it. Looking for me, punks? I love it. I love it. This one, and these are really nice brand new bags and boards. just sometimes you get comics and then are in these old grungy bags and boards and you redo them any after the fact because you don't want that just grungy crap in your boxes of comics. But these from Talented Online are perfectly sharp, brand new, crystal clear bags and boards. This is Detective Comics number 513. Another awesome cover. Oh no, Batman, what has Two-Face done to you? Next, Detective Comics 560 from March of 1986. Time for reflection, a time for fear. Okay. This next one is a lot, and I don't know how. Oh, they put the two books inside another sleeve because they sold it as a lot. So I'll hold on to that. Maybe I could salvage that sleeve, throw a board in it. This is Detective Comics 582 from January 88. This is a duplicate. I didn't mean to do that, but I saw that there were two books in this lot. The other one is Detective 584, March of 88. They're not even sequential, so I'm not sure why they were together in a lot, but I ended up with these, even though I already have this one. So I'm starting to, even though I said I don't want to sell comics, I don't want to get into that aspect of it, I'm starting to have a lot of duplicates. And I might start putting some little small lots together on eBay or something, or maybe to try and find people to trade with locally. That would be a lot more fun, I think. This one, I remember I used to have. I didn't get it back with when I got back my collection. And I'll just say real quick, as I go through my collection that was returned to me last weekend, it's probably about 3/4 of my collection. I think there's some stuff that isn't there anymore. And I'm only bringing this up because as I get a grip on what I have and what I don't have, I'm buying back some of the stuff that I don't have. And I'm not making any commentary on where they went. I don't care. When I contacted my friend back and said, can I have my comic books back? He would have had every right to tell me to go fly a kite or to say, no, I sold them when you gave them to me. Like, so I don't care, and I'm not making any kind of judgment on that, but I am just kind of throwing it out there that things like this is a Detective 580, November 1987. I know I had a copy of this book, and it's not in with my stuff, so you'll see more of that. I may mention as these haul videos go on, because now that I know what I have and what I don't, I'm trying to fill in some gaps of things that I had that aren't there anymore. Detective Comics 581, December 1987. Tell me these covers aren't all amazing. Detective Comics 571, February 87. This one, incredible, incredible. Condition's a little bit more worn out than some of these other books we've seen. But man, I would put that on a poster and hang it on the wall. That's amazing. All right, this next one is something that I know I used to have, and it's one of those minor keys that has just been always cheap, and I think any self-respecting Batman fan needs to have it. It's Detective 608, The First Appearance of Anarchy. I had this one, don't know where it is, don't know what happened to it. Wasn't with the stuff that got returned to me. And then this one, 609, I already have a copy of this, but these two were in a lot. So next, Detective Comics 641, we're getting a little bit more modern. This is from 92. I don't know what caught my eye on this one. It's a cool looking cover, but it's not like, oh my God, that looks so great. Detective Comics 644, May of 1992, Electric City, Part 1. Looks pretty cool. Here's one that's not detective. Batman, number 412 from October 1987, introducing the mime. The mime, of course, became a major character. This is a major key. I'm just kidding. This was the same price as all the other ones, $3 or whatever. And then lastly, since we're off the Detective Comics train, this is another lot of books from the Legends of the Dark Knight series. This is the storyline Heat. And these are in damn near mint condition. Heat Part 1, Legends of the Dark Knight, number 46. Heat Part 2, Legend of the Dark Knight, 47. This is a Catwoman story. Heat Part 3, Legend of the Dark Knight, 48. And last book for the day, Heat Part 4, Legends of the Dark Knight, Part 49. So I hope you enjoyed that haul. I have to thank all the new subscribers. We hit 40 subscribers, which is double. It's approximately double the amount of subscribers I had when I relaunched this channel a couple weeks ago. So I really, really appreciate all the people who have come on board. I'm headed for triple digits, baby. So stick around. I'm going to do more of those three packs probably tomorrow, and we'll see if we get any good books out of those. So thanks again, and I'll see you next time.